Are you planning your dream vacation or packing your bags for an exciting trip to a sunny destination? Well, the key to an amazing trip starts with preparation. And in this video, we'll explore the top tips and evidence-based strategies for preventing the uncomfortable nuisance of traveler's diarrhea, ensuring that you have a worry-free and enjoyable vacation. Traveler's diarrhea can be caused by various pathogens, including bacteria like E. coli and Salmonella, viruses like norovirus, and even parasites. These nasty germs are typically transmitted through contaminated food, water, dishes, and cutlery. Now, the symptoms of traveler's diarrhea can vary from mild abdominal cramps, weakness, nausea, and frequent bowel movements to more severe cases that can be characterized by high fever and even bloody stools. But if you plan ahead, you can easily avoid these issues. When it comes to prevention, there are a few things to keep in mind, and you do have a couple of options available to you. First off, there are some specific probiotic strains that have been shown to be effective for prevention of traveler's diarrhea, which we will discuss in a moment. There is also an oral vaccine for traveler's diarrhea that needs to be taken prior to travel. In addition to this, I'm going to give you some important tips to follow while on vacation to ensure you stay healthy and free of any unwanted guests or surprises. When it comes to probiotics for prevention of traveler's diarrhea, I wanted to know what the best evidence was for this based on the latest research and what specific products might be available at our local pharmacy or health food store. In order to get the most up-to-date information, I spoke with the author of the Clinical Guide to Probiotics in Canada, Dragana Skokovic-Sunjic, and I've asked her to explain to us what our options are.
We have fairly substantial evidence for few specific probiotic strains. As you know, probiotics are very, very popular. People are using them and they have been promoted for many different reasons and issues. What is still missing is really connecting a specific strain for specific purpose, because they do not all have the same effect. When it comes to traveler's diarrhea, few strains that have been proven very effective and extensively researched are available in Canada, and they are listed in the Clinical Guide to Probiotic Products. I would encourage you to check it out online. But when I talk about specific strains, I'll tell you that one of them with most of the evidence is Saccharomyces boulardii, but not any kind of Saccharomyces boulardii, because when I say Saccharomyces boulardii, it's a whole family of probiotic yeast. And the one that has been proven very effective is CNCMI745. I'm actually right now cheating. I'm looking up at the printed copy of the guide because I cannot remember those strains. Nobody can. So this is why using and talking about brand names is usually helpful and practical. I have to say I have no commercial ties with those probiotic makers or do not have any kickbacks from the companies making them. But the strain that I mentioned for Saccharomyces boulardii is called Florastor in Canada. The second strain that has been researched for this particular purpose is Lactobacillus rhamnosus GG, and it's sold under name of Culturelle. There are a few other brand names for the same strain, and I do encourage you to check the guide and see what they are. When we talk about probiotics as a prevention of traveler's diarrhea, that means starting to take those probiotics couple of weeks before your travel. This depends on where you're going, how safe the food is there, where you're staying, and what is your previous experience with traveler's diarrhea while traveling. If you have no problems, you're staying in a resort with a good supply of food, etc., you might take only a week before, take it throughout the stay there, and maybe for a couple of days after you get back. That's the recommendation with the best level of evidence to prevent the problem.
In addition to probiotics, the other option worth discussing is an oral vaccine, which in Canada is marketed under the name dukoral. This vaccine is not injected into your arm, but instead, this is a liquid that is taken orally in two separate doses, the first being a few weeks before your trip, and the second dose being taken at least 1 week prior to departure. Dukoral helps to protect the body from gastrointestinal upset that can be caused by E. coli and cholera. Now, the protection provided by Dukoral vaccine begins 1 week after the second dose and lasts for about 3 months. So it's important to keep that in mind when you're getting ready for your trip. Dukoral can be used by children as young as 2 years of age, though it's not recommended for pregnant women, so it's important to keep that in mind.
Have you seen any studies comparing probiotics to, say, Dukoral for prevention?
There's really no head-to-head study with the Dukoral and probiotics as a prevention. However, when you look at the number needed to treat, which basically tells us how effective the prevention intervention is, the number needed to treat is much smaller for probiotics compared to Dukoral. So that means when people take Dukoral, certain number of patients will actually get benefit. But when the same amount of patients take probiotic, more patients will get benefit if they take probiotic for prevention.
Now, there are a few additional things to keep top of mind while you are on vacation. And following these key tips will help keep you and your intestines happy. So what does a pharmacist bring on vacation as far as medication goes? The answer is I actually bring quite a few things, and I'm going to share a couple of them with you here. First of all, if you do take any medication, make sure that you always put it in your carry-on to prevent it getting lost or not arriving at your destination with you. Products like Pepto-Bismol can also be helpful for the symptoms of traveler's diarrhea. Probiotics like Lactobacillus rhamnosus and Saccharomyces boulardii, seen here, may also provide some benefit. Today, we aren't going to go in depth into other travel vaccines, but there are vaccines available for travel that can help protect you from hepatitis A and B that are known as Twinrix or Havrix. Also, depending on your destination, there may be other vaccinations that would be recommended. So it'd be best to consult with a pharmacist or primary care provider at least 4 weeks prior to your trip to ensure that you can plan which vaccinations might be needed and ensure that you are able to have these in time to have a good immune response mounted before you leave. Once you've reached your destination, it's important to do a few things well. You always want to make sure that you're consuming water that is safe for you. So drink only boiled, bottled, or carbonated beverages. Avoid bottled drinks if the cap is not sealed and intact. Alcohol also does not sterilize water or ice, so be careful with alcoholic beverages. As far as food goes, it's important to eat fruit and vegetables only if they've been washed in safe water and peeled. Avoid salads, raw vegetables, leftovers, and condiments from open bottles, and be cautious with food from street vendors. Wash your hands with soap and water before eating, and if your hands aren't visibly dirty, alcohol-based sanitizers, which I always take with me on the plane as well, are also effective. So what happens if you do still end up with traveler's diarrhea or an upset stomach? Well, if you do have diarrhea, it's important to consume plenty of clear fluids such as water, diluted fruit juices, or oral rehydration salt solutions to help prevent dehydration. For cases of mild traveler's diarrhea that might threaten to disrupt your plans, you can consider bringing medications like loperamide, otherwise known as Imodium, or another medication known as Lomotil. These can help with symptoms like tummy pains. It also helps to slow down the cramping of the intestines. Now, it's best to purchase these medications from your community prior to travel, as regulations and storage requirements may not be the same in the area you are traveling to. So if you have followed all of these tips, and for whatever reason, you still end up with traveler's diarrhea, what do you need to know? And what signs should you watch out for? Typically, traveler's diarrhea lasts around 3 to 5 days. Most cases do resolve without specific treatment. However, if you experience severe traveler's diarrhea with more than 6 episodes of diarrhea in 24 hours, if you have blood or mucus in your stools, high fever, or severe stomach pain, seek medical attention immediately. You may need intravenous fluids or even antibiotics. When traveling to certain countries outside of North America, there may be a tendency for resorts or other individuals to recommend the use of antibiotics without a prescription. It's important to avoid using antibiotics routinely, as their overuse can lead to something called antibiotic resistance. In some cases, preventative antibiotics may be considered for people with specific medical conditions, so do always consult your physician or travel health practitioner for guidance if you are in doubt. While traveler's diarrhea can certainly disrupt your vacation, following these preventative measures can significantly reduce your risk. I hope this has been helpful, and I hope you can stay safe, stay healthy, and enjoy your journey without the worries of traveler's diarrhea. I can't believe I ended the script that way.